Yes.
Okay, so we are going to talk about applications of the definite integral. In particular, we're going to talk about areas and solids of revolution. So let's talk about applications of the definite integral. In particular, today we're going to focus on finding the area of regions and finding volumes of solids of revolution. Okay, so I have here, let's say, this is a typical example where we have a parabola and a line. The parabola is y equals x squared. The line is given by y equals x plus 2. And let's say I want to find areas of certain regions, and in particular, let's say I have this region 1 and this is region 2. So let's look at the first problem, which is let's find the area of region 1. Area of region 1, in order to find that, we can do vertical strips, okay, a representative element of area, this vertical rectangle, okay? And we use the formula for the area of a rectangle. Area of a rectangle is length times width, okay? So if we look at the length here, the length is this height, which is really the y of the line. The y of the line is x plus 2, right? And the y of the parabola, which is x squared. So the length is x plus 2 for the line minus x squared for the parabola. Okay, did you get that? So the y above, so basically it's the y above minus the y below, okay? And of course the thickness of this is dx, okay? So the width is dx. Now if we want to the area, then we have to integrate from here to here, okay? So what do we need to do? We need to find what? Points of intersection, right? So if we want to find the points of intersection, find the intersection of the two curves, we can equate the y, so we have x squared is equal to x plus 2. Then we get x squared minus x minus 2 is 0. We can factor this to get x minus 2, x plus 1 is 0, so giving us the values x equals 2 or x equals negative 1. We might as well get the y coordinates because later on I'll play with these some more, okay? So when x is 2, we want the y coordinate. The y coordinate is obtained by substituting 2 in either one of these equations, right? So you get y is 4. When x is negative 1, you'll get y is 1. That's y, right? Okay, y is 1. So therefore, this point here is really 2, 4. And this point is negative 1, 1, okay? So therefore, again, going back to the problem, we want the area. So this is a representative element of area. We integrate this. We let this go from here to there, right? So notice it's like, yeah, we left several of these, okay? So we just let our integral run from the x here to the x there. What's the x here?
Negative 1.
Negative
2.
1, and then you have 2. And then you just copy this, okay? So that's how you find the area of region 1. Let's say I want to find the area of region 2 or R2. Well, let's look here. So R2 is, let me just do it here. So R2 is bounded by, well, you notice that this is y equals x squared here, right? And this is y equals x plus 2. This is R2 that I'm interested in, this region. It's bounded by the two curves and the x-axis. Okay, how are we going to do that if it's like that? Well, if we can do it either, we can do it like this, we can do a vertical element of area or vertical strip. However, if we do that, what do we have to, what do we notice? If we run this vertical strip from here to there, as soon as you cross this line, what happens?
D exchanges.
This thing, the boundary here changes, right? So actually, if we were to do vertical strips, then we will need 2.
What do you mean by changes?
Well, because here you notice that the boundary here is the line, right?
Oh, I see what you mean. Okay.
And once you cross over here where they intersect, the boundary is the parabola,
okay.
Right? So if we insist on using vertical strips or vertical elements of area, then we will have to do it in 2 pieces,
mm-hmm.
Right? Okay? This first guy is what? Length
y
times width, right? The length is this, the y of the line. What's the y of the line?
Dy.
It's x plus 2, right?
Oh.
Times the width, which is dx, right?
Not dy. Or dx.
Not,
dx.
It's dx,
change
right?
Dx.
That's the width, it's the dx. This is the x-axis,
oh, yeah,
this is the change in the x, okay? And this guy will run from what to what? What is this point here where y equals x plus 2 will intersect the x-axis? This is y equals x plus 2. It will hit the x-axis when y is 0. So this is x equals negative 2. Right? Okay. So therefore, you can run this integral from negative 2 to negative 1. Did you get that? So that's for this portion. Correct?
No, but in chapter 6, we could
Let's see. Let me finish and then you can ask your questions after. Okay. Okay, and then now here we have, we cross over, right? And this is where you have x equals negative 1, right? Then we cross and we get this. Let's see, I don't think I drew this quite correctly. I think the parabola went like that already, right? Okay. So actually it drops to 0 there. Okay, so this is 0. Okay, so now we'll have length times width. So what is the length of this rectangle?
X squared.
The length of this rectangle is the y of this curve. It's y here minus y here, but the y here is really 0, right? Yeah. Okay, so therefore it's x squared. Dx is the width, right?
Yeah.
Okay, mm-hmm. And you integrate that from here. You
negative
run the rectangle from here to here, so it's from
negative
1 to 0. So that will be the area of region 1. If you insist on doing vertical elements of area. However, of course, we can do it another way, right? What's the other way we could have done it? Let me just do it again here. Yeah, you can have horizontal strip, right? A horizontal strip here. Let's just label the points here. This is 0, 0. This was, what was this? Negative 1, 1, right? And this is negative 2, 0. Okay. So this is good in the sense that what? If you want the area, it's really just a matter of running this from bottom to top, right? When you run this strip from bottom to top, do you see, do you notice if any change in the boundaries?
Yeah.
Yeah.
The boundaries are the same always, right?
Yeah.
What the boundaries will be what? Now, if you have a horizontal strip, you see the x, this is the x of the parabola, right?
Yeah.
And this is the x of the line. Right?
Okay.
So where if it's vertical, it's y minus y, right? If it's horizontal, it's x minus x, right? Now what is the x of the parabola? Let's see, the parabola's equation was what? Y equals x squared, right? If you want to solve this for x, then you get x equals plus or minus radical y. Now which one do you want? Notice we're to the left of the x of the y-axis. We're on the left of the y-axis, so therefore this one is really negative grad y.
Mm-hmm.
Did you get that? Okay, negative the square root of y. Now this line was y equals x plus 2. Therefore, if we want to get the x of this line, what do we get?
x equals y minus 2,
right? Okay. So if we did this horizontal strip, so the area will be the length. The length is the x of this, which is negative square root of y, right? Minus this x here, which is what? Where was I?
Y minus 2,
then that will become minus y plus 2, correct? And the width, of course, of this rectangle being
dy.
Horizontal is dy. And you run it from the bottom, which is y equals 0. Now it's y, right? This is y equals 0 to y equals
1.
Okay?
Mm-hmm.
That's your area. And these two guys should be equal. Okay? If we did it correctly, those two answers should be the same number. Okay? Okay, question.